Hello, Libra. Welcome to your weekly reading. This is your forecast for the week ahead, April the 24th through the 30th, 2023. For all Libras that may be watching, Libra suns, moons, risings, Libras on the house cusp, if you have your sun in the seventh house or Venus in Libra, feel free to watch this reading. Cross watchers are also welcome. Just keep in mind, these are general readings and I am reading for the sign of Libra, so the messages are geared towards them, not the cross watcher, for example. Personal private tarot readings down below in the description. You can find my website scheduling page down there as well as up in the right hand corner. Just click that eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. If you don't want to watch me shuffle, there's timestamps. I think on Monday morning I'll be able to timestamp the actual reading times. But I do have one quick announcement, guys. I wanted to let you guys know I will be offering a Money Magic Manifestation Workshop in the month of May, at the end of May, May 20th, I believe that's a Saturday, at 11 a.m. Central. It will be held virtually. It's a 90-minute session, 90-minute workshop. I'll be showing you precise strategies and tips and actual money magic on how to manifest whatever number you want to manifest in a very quick amount of time. This is proven. I have done this in my own life. I'm going to show you the most precise, most specific secret way of doing this. It is I'm going to call it a tip of the trade. So no one else has this magic available to them. I mean, no one on the internet is showing you what I'm going to show you. So if you are interested in signing up, there are limited spaces. I have 10 spots available right now. Make sure that you do so. I would say before probably the second week of May going into because by the 20th, you need to have all your supplies ready. I'll have to send out a few things to you. Okay. Everyone is going to get a little box with everything they need for the workshop. Okay. So if that's something that interests you, please check that out. I will put it down below in the description below all the information for this video. It'll be the first line you see below that information, as well as up in the right-hand corner, okay? Libra, for your reading today, we are using the Alchemia Tarot deck. This is a Japanese tarot deck. It is a rare tarot deck. I mean, they're out there, but all of it's in Japanese here. So the author is Eiko or Ako Morimura, and the publisher is Takaki Japan. That's what it looks like. Okay, I'll put that down below in the description for you guys. Then, we're not using traditional oracle cards today. I'm using these spell cards. The Practical Witch's spell deck here, 100 spells for love, happiness, and success. I'll be drawing some cards for you to see what will help you manifest what you need this week, what kind of spell will work for you best this week. Okay, and here is a little QR code. It says tarotdeck.top, and you can scan that in to get more information on this. Although I will say, I think I got this off the Wish app. Okay, the Alchemia Tarot deck, you would have to look for that on eBay or something, because it's a rare deck. I don't think you can find that on Amazon or whatever, or even at your bookstore. It would be sort of a collector's item. So anyway, and I still haven't been able to find the translation to the guidebook. People have asked me before, do you have a translation for that guidebook? I do not have a Japanese to English translation for that guidebook, so I don't know where I could possibly find that. Maybe someone out there knows. Who knows? We're looking at 6 cards for your week ahead, Libra. And Spirit, show me, what are the most important messages and energies for the sign of Libra this week? The Page of Swords came out, okay? You could be watching videos this week. You could be watching this reading. Someone could be observing. This is my investigative journalist card. They want to know who, what, where, when, why, and how. All right, so you're paying attention to someone here. Let's see. Give me 6 cards for Libra's week ahead. Show me, what do they need to know, Spirit? Like, share, comment, and subscribe, guys. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button right now. Click all notifications so you always be notified whenever I do upload a weekly forecast or whatever reading I'm doing for your sign. Let us go ahead and cut this deck. Okay. Pardon me. I don't know why. I don't know. I said pardon me because the cards are like a little bit messing with me today. Okay. Come on, Libra. Come on, Libra. Let's see what we got. Let's see what you got. I had to put on my robe. I was getting a little chilly in here. I like to maintain a constant body temperature of probably typically something warmer than the average human would probably like, I do run cool. My hands run cold. Cold hands, you know, cold hands, warm heart. So maybe that resonates with you. Maybe you also have cold hands right now. But my hands are warm. I'm saying I usually have cold hands. Queen of Pentacles reversed here. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn energy. You could be dealing with an earth sign this week. This person is neglecting themselves. They may not be feeling well. This could be also laziness, stubbornness. We're not getting out in nature enough. Someone is not doing well here. This could be someone's mother. Page of Swords reversed. There's the Page of Swords. Someone is spying on this Queen of Pentacles. Who is this? Three of Swords. Someone is heartbroken here. Someone has a lot. This is Libra's energy. Three of Swords, Wheel of Fortune. Okay, Libra, I'm going to say you have a broken heart. You could be spying on this earth sign. This could be someone that you are missing. Or flip the script. This is them. They're spying on you and they're not doing well. This person, it could be a masculine or a feminine energy, but if they're coming up as a Queen of Pentacles in reverse, that is not your air sign energy. So, unless you have earth in your chart. I don't know what that's about. You tell me. How you see yourself today? Page of Pentacles. Are you an earth sign? Okay, you could have earth in your chart. Well, you're learning something new this week. It could have to do with money, finances. I feel like you're paying attention to the details. You're being very careful about something. Okay, this is like precision, doing something very, in a very careful manner. You're examining something very closely. This also could have to do with your body or a message that you could find on a walk or whatever, doing something outside. This is like a message from the earth, basically. You could be looking at someone's photo here, like on your phone or something like that, or someone could be doing this to you. I feel like someone's really admiring this pentacle. So you could be weighing the pros and cons of a situation here. Do you want this? Is this something that you're interested in? You might need to learn more about it. Okay. I would focus more on the negatives as well. If you're weighing the pros and cons, whatever this is, what is the theme for your week ahead? The Seven of Pentacles, Taurus's energy, waiting for results on something here. You've already had some sort of success, or someone's had some sort of success with you. We're not ready to harvest these fruits yet, but they are growing. They are maturing. There's a little bit more work that needs to be done. You may be taking stock of something here, like maybe inventory, or for example, if you run a business, or if you are... This could be any area of your life. It is pentacles, so we're dealing with things that we can touch, feel, see, taste, etc. Like something tangible here you're taking stock of. Seems like you're waiting for results on that. What happened in your past? The Ten of Pentacles in reverse. There was a severe loss here. This could also include exile from a family situation, a loss of inheritance, a loss of a great amount of wealth here. This might have been the end of a long-term relationship, or financial security here was threatened. Someone may have been casted out of your community or your circle, or maybe this is something that happened to someone that you know here. It does feel like we're back to waiting for results, though. So something happened to Three Pentacles, which it would be either a third-party situation, a relationship, or an employment situation. Three Pentacles have gone missing here. Now, I'm not saying those are your pentacles. We have a lot of Earth coming up in this reading. So this has to do with your material structure, your material world here. We're talking about your career, your job, your finances, maybe a relationship. What is the challenge for you this week? Justice. That's you. So you are in the challenge position this week. That's interesting. I want to say get out of your own way here. Allow this justice to take place. You are possibly receiving some karma as well. Okay, this could be positive or negative. In the challenge position, I don't know if this is going to go in your favor. I don't know if the scales are balanced in the challenge position. In the challenge position, the justice card is in the reverse position. So someone here is being selfish, possibly, or weighing their own needs above everyone else. It's possible. Now, you could be dealing with a court of law, something having to do with the justice system, or some sort of karma. Maybe you're dealing with another Libra this week as well, like a Libra rising, a Libra moon, a Libra sun, or something like that. Yeah, that's also a possibility. What is the lesson you're learning now? The Hanged Man in reverse. This talks about inflexibility. Someone here is expecting the other person to bend the knee. This is also someone that is not ready to release an idea out into the world. They would rather think about it some more. They would rather they've already looked at something from another perspective. They've already been enlightened. So this is my awakened dreamer card, meaning they're still dreaming, but they're awake. But so they're not taking action. I don't know. This is Pisces energy. Notice how the Hanged Man reverse is looking at the Justice card. It feels to me like someone is looking at you as the answer to all their problems, or looking for you to weigh out something here. But they're not taking action. They're waiting for something is pending, is how I feel. Something is pending here. I feel like you're taking your time with a decision, because in the past you lost something here that was very, very expensive, precious to you. Took you a long time to accumulate, possibly. So I do feel like you're going to be more careful this time. That is why justice is in the challenge position, because you're not fucking around. You are taking your time, you're being careful, and you are counting. You are counting carefully, and you're being very diligent. Okay, what is the gift you will receive? Strength in reverse. This person, whoever you're dealing with here, could be a Leo, another Libra, a Pisces, an Earth sign. This person does not have good self-esteem. They are weak. Okay, they are acting on impulse. Okay, they can't control themselves. They have no inner integrity, inner strength, courage, all of these things here. So this person is not going to be able to, I don't know, contain themselves, hold back, resist. They don't have discipline. They're not disciplined. That's why they're looking at you, because you are disciplined, Libra. Tell me more about justice reversed. Strength reversed. Knight of Wands. In the reverse. I'll just put it there. Nine of Wands reversed. Okay. This is you resisting getting involved in a situation where you could easily run in for the easy win. You could easily score, do whatever. You could easily if this is another person you're interested, you could easily get this person. You could easily have this person. You could easily. You're not going to, though. And you're not going to let this person do that to you either. So this is you being careful about your decisions. Okay, maybe you are being selfish. I feel like that's the karma. It's that you can afford to be selfish right now a little bit, because in the past of how much crap happened back here. I'll put that down there because I really was trying to clarify the strength in reverse card. You may very well be dealing with a fire sign like a Leo, but I feel like this person, they could be holding back with you, resisting getting involved. But you know, and this could involve a marriage. This could involve a contract as well. I just feel like things are, you're taking your time. What is this person bringing to the table? Someone was exiled here from a family situation or a long-term relationship. You want justice. You want justice for something here. Okay. Look, you could be dealing with someone that is neglectful, uncaring, lazy. They don't, you know, they're not keeping up on their side of the bargain here. Tell me more. Tell me more for Libra here this week. Give me a spell for Libra. Okay, we have an everyday spell, two everyday spells. I'll take this one. Okay. Uh-oh. Yeah, Libra, something here. I've been feeling this energy. It feels to me like something is slipping out of my hands here. Give me a second. Okay. Something's real slippery. Okay. I feel like something's not stable. That's how it feels. It's like it could slip out of your hands at any moment, and you have to treat it so carefully. Are you walking on eggshells or something? I don't know. I feel like you are being more careful, though, this time with something or someone. Everyday spells. Open your third eye. Okay. Saffron has long been used to bring forth intuition and heightened psychic powers. Saffron water is made by steeping 1 teaspoon of saffron in 2 cups of boiled, distilled water. Dip your hands in the water, touch your third eye at the center of your forehead, and say aloud, Ishtar, Athena, Diana, Astarte. Fill me with your presence. This night I am whole. I am at peace. With each breath you do inspire, so mote it be. So someone here has not opened their third eye. I don't know. This could be someone you're dealing with. Like I said, this here is about an awakening. The crown chakra is highlighted here. So someone needs to open their third eye. They're not seeing something. They're not spiritually awakened. This could also be good for cleansing that area too, cleansing your third eye. Anyway, Libra, this is what I have for you. Some spiritual messages coming through here. I would stay away from drinking tap water, okay, because it does have buildup from like something that can block your pineal gland, like fluoride. I would also stay away from fluoride in the toothpaste, fluoride in, you know, mouthwashes and stuff like that. They also do put fluoride in drinking water, which is why I tend to not drink right out of the tap. You may have a calcified pineal gland or third eye. Someone may need to clear that out. Okay. So here's a way to open that up. Okay, so anyway, I hope this reading has helped you. Thank you for watching. Sending you off with much love and light. Many blessings. Take care, Libra.